All right, we're here at 360 heat race number one winner Ryan Giles. You also picked up quick time. You got to be feeling good tonight.
I do. Yeah, the car's definitely working really well. I can't thank Al Parker enough for that. You know, we were kind of back and forth on what to do with the gear and tune up there before the heat race, and luckily he told me to leave it because it's been quick, and see what we can put together for the feature. My wife's here tonight. She came down to surprise me for my birthday, and I told her, so we're going to set quick time, win the heat, and win the feature. So I haven't been made a liar yet, so hopefully we can keep it going.
Well, you've been up there the past couple weeks, and now you finally set quick time. You finally got the heat race win. What's different about this week as opposed to the weeks prior?
We just honestly found just a little bit in the car I've been missing. I don't know, speed-wise, anything really has been there. It's just getting me comfortable in the car and the feeling that I really need. And once we found that, we haven't really been out of the top five since. So hopefully we can keep it going as long as we can. But if not, we had fun doing it and try and get a win knocked off before we're out of the top five.
We're looking great out there. And I also heard rumor that it was your birthday yesterday. And so everyone at Knoxville Raceway, I would like to wish you a very happy birthday and best luck for you in the rest of the night.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right, we're here at 360 heat race number two winner Tony Shilling. Right from the start, there was a big crash, and you were right in the thick of things. How'd you get out of it, and what was your perspective on the crash?
Oh, you know, it looked like Manhattan maybe didn't take off, and I kind of gave myself enough room kind of leading up there because I was a little worried about what he may do going into one anyway. So we kind of just give ourselves some room there, and I don't know, luckily stuck through it. Got started on the pole of the heat race there, or the outside, and I don't know, I thought we were going to be pretty tough to beat if I could get up rolling on the cushion. There's some big bumps and a few ledges that kind of threw us off. So we're going to have to tune in and try to miss that if we want to win this thing.
And you had a pretty decent qualifying time. You timed in eighth and you won your eighth. How's the car feeling tonight?
You know, the car's real good. We've been real fast. Jeff Woodruff's got it running good. You know, it seems like maybe we'll finally hit the invert right tonight and maybe get a front row starting spot. You know, I don't know. We've been close, so maybe tonight's the night.
And what are some changes that you've made? What are some changes that you've been making to the car so that way you get your car running well and how you like it?
Well, you know, I'm worried tonight because I don't necessarily like to run the bottom. You know, we've been running it a lot this year, and right now the bottom's awfully sloppy. But if it comes in, I'm a little worried because, you know, I know there's a lot of good guys on the bottom. So we're going to have to get me tuned in to run both lines, or else I'm going to struggle to, you know, run away with the feature.
Well, thank you very much, Tony. You're looking great out there, and I wish you best luck for the night to come.
Thanks, AJ.
All right, we're here at 360 heat race number three winner Tyler Groenendyk. You started in the front row and you led the race wire to wire. How's the car feeling tonight?
We're a lot better tonight than we have been. I got to give a huge shout out to my friend and my shot guy, James Kinder, with Midwest Speed Shop. He's up here tonight kind of giving us some fine-tuning adjustments on this car, getting us a lot closer to where we need to be. So thankful for him to come up and help us out. Thankful for my team. They're working hard even when we've been struggling here the last few weeks, and all the marketing partners and people that just let me be here, man. It's just a blessing to be here racing in Knoxville.
And you said you've made a few changes to the car. What kind of changes are you making to the car to get yourself more preparation in tune for races come here in Knoxville?
It's mostly just fine-tuning stuff, you know, a little bit, moving weight around on the car, and really nothing big, just a lot of little things that are adding up to make a big difference.
We're looking good out there, and you also, finally, the 360 heat race went wire to wire without a big red, and I wish you best luck for the night to come.
Yeah, thank you very much.